Hey everybody, it's the Ancient Meddler back again, and I'm going to be doing something a little different today. I'm going to be doing a review of a new album that came out. It's from a band called Red Cain, which I've never heard of before. And they are a power metal band from Alberta, Canada that started back in 2016. So this is a new album called Näe'bliss, and we're going to be checking it out. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to play parts of each song. I'm going to do like 30 seconds from the beginning, 30 seconds from the middle, 30 seconds toward the end, something like that. And we'll hit each song on the album so we can get a good sample of it. And then I'll give you what I think my rating of it is overall and see how that goes. It's the first time doing it, so I don't know how this is going to play out, but we'll give it a shot. So the first song on the album is called Fisher King. And so let's take a listen. All right, that's the first part of the song. The introduction, the opening of it was really cool. I like the like that crunchiness of the guitars. It's really neat. Vocals are good. They're a little very flowing and kind of ethereal, kind of mystical sounding, right? Let's jump into the middle of this. I have no idea where it's going to be, so we're just going to pop in. Ooh, let's back up a little. There we go. That was just a taste, but luckily I landed on the guitar solo. That was awesome. That was a really good solo. All right, I'm going to pop to the end of this. More towards the end. Not exactly the end. All right, that's the tune Fisher King. It's a solid... song right there. I like that. All right, next it's called Blight. Let's go and check that out. Ooh, acoustic. All right. It's almost jazzy. It's kind of cool. It's different. Let's jump in the middle. Ooh, I like that. Father of lies, Lord of the Queen, Shepherd of the Night, come whisper my name. Oh, wow. Oh, quick Lord, Lord of the Queen, Father of all, whisper my name. It's got harsh vocals, but it's not super harsh, and it's legible, or legible, is that, you say legible for speaking? I don't know. Sorry, I'm eating breakfast, and I didn't think you guys wanted to watch, so. But I am drinking coffee from my Yorkie cup. Let's go to the end of this one. This is still Blight. All right, what I read was, I read that they are power metal, but I'm hearing other influences as well, right? So, melodic death metal or something. So far, it's good. The vocals are interesting. Very, I don't know how to describe it. Smooth, flowing, kind of reminds me of this guy, oh, I forget his name, but he was he had a group called Him. I think he's Swedish. Somewhere in Europe. I probably shouldn't say things like that to disenfranchise my Swedish listeners. I'm not sure where he's from. But, you know, it's kind of like that almost gothic kind of sound. So, and the imagery is gothic, too, so maybe there's some gothic influences. The next song is called The Great Hunt. Let's check that one out. Very theatrical. That's cool. I like how it jumped into that with the heavy bass and all that. Nice. All right, let's jump into the middle. Slap dab in the middle. This is a 4:09. This is very progressive too. It's like it's cool. It's got the harmonies there and the singing, the vocalization of that part was really good. Jump to the end. All right. Next one's called We Are Chaos. I would definitely, I don't know, maybe their other, their earlier albums were more power metal, because what I read from a respectable source said they're a Canadian power metal band. I'm not hearing power metal at all, because I love power metal, right? So this is much more melodic death metal, gothic metal, that kind of thing. We're just going to move on to the next song. It's called Sight Blinder. Oh, yeah. Sorry, I'm reaching my time limit. I'm trying really hard not to abuse their copyright by playing everything. I'll probably pick like one of the better songs on the album, and maybe I'll do like a full reaction to the whole song for you guys. Let's see how this goes. So far, I'm digging this. This is very prog metal, man. It's like the keyboards, the staccato nature of that, the overlaying of the different guitars. And the it's just the complex nature of that little part of the composition. It's very prog. So, not sure why anybody would think this is power metal. Let's jump towards the end of this song. Yeah, it's cool. This is 2 minutes into this thing. 220. It's only 2 minutes and 47 seconds long, so it's not a very long one. All right. Next one's called The Man Who Can't Forget Part One, and then there's three more songs left. The Man Who Can't Forget Part One, Crane of Malkir, which is part two, Fires of Heaven. So let's jump into The Man Who Can't Forget Part One. All right, that almost sounds power metal. Yeah.
Darkness of his night, the doom that gave no warning.
Right, just whetting your appetite. I like this song, so this is really good. It's 2 minutes and 38 seconds. Yeah, this is really cool. I'm getting a feel as I hear more of the vocals. It's very reminiscent to me of some of the Visual K bands from Japan, like Versailles or the like Hisaki Grace Project or Malice Mizer. They've got that kind of it's not opera, right? It's not that formal, but it's very theatrical way of singing. And I like that because it sets the tone, right? It really meshes well with the whole gothic theme that's going on here. So that was interesting. I'll jump somewhere down the line on the song. Right, it's pretty good. Now we're going to jump into the part two, which is Crane of Malkir. Malkir? Thank you. All right, that's awesome. Jump somewhere in the middle. I was going to jump on into the last song. It's called Fires of Heaven. It's 8 minutes and 4 seconds long, so that's a pretty long one. It's the longest one on the album. Light was 6:37, so yeah, 8 minutes and 4 seconds. I like this song the most. This is the best one for me on this album so far. I haven't got to the vocals yet. This is just the beginning. I'm really liking it. Yeah, this one definitely has some kind of power metal feel to it more than the rest. And it's great that they're not one genre. I don't require, for me to appreciate a band. They don't have to just be stuck and pigeonholed into one genre or another. I like a band to explore what they want to explore the way they want to explore it, and then share it with us. You know, and either we like it or we don't, right? So don't feel like just because some guy who wrote a magazine article said you're power metal, or I'm sitting here saying it doesn't sound like power metal to me. It sounds like melodic death metal, or it sounds like gothic metal, or whatever. It doesn't matter. It's all labels, man. We've had enough labels in this world. We don't need any more. This is just music, and it's good, and I like it, so. All right, let's jump in the middle. All right, that's good. Now let's try it way over here. Yeah. It's a very big production, very, like I said before, theatrical, and I like that. But this could be the soundtrack to a movie. All right, let's go just jump towards the end of this and see. This is the last song in the album, so this will be the end of the album. I don't want to give away the, you know, the ending of a novel. Listen to those drums. That's fast. I wonder how many BPM that is, because that's a lot. Digging it. I really like Canadian metal. There was a band a few years ago that I really liked a lot, but they broke up. Maybe I'll do something about them sometime. But anyway, this is Red Cain we're talking about, not other bands. So, in the great Canadian tradition of Bob and Doug and Geddy Lee and the Goat Rider's Horde. I'm digging it. This was good. But it didn't melt my brain. So I'd say, you know, it gets a solid 4 of these. I got to come up with like a logo. 4 devil horns. Maybe 4 1/4. It's pretty good. Pretty good. Not great. Could be better. So there's room for improvement. Always. Unless you're Judas Priest. All right. So, 4 out of 5. Not bad. I may do an individual reaction to the Fires of Heaven song because I liked it. Anyway, appreciate you hanging out. Make sure you go by and visit Red Cain's website. I'll put a link in the description. A link to their channel on YouTube. So go support them if you like it and check them out and buy their records. Do people still buy records these days? And if you like my content, feel free to comment. If you don't like it, feel free to comment. If you don't like me wearing AC/DC, you can tell me that I'm lame. And then, you know, make sure you subscribe if you want to hear more of this and hit the little ding dong if you want to know when I put out new things. So see you around.